How tight should your cylinder valve be? Quarter turn back or no? It's time for quick tips. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Divers Ready. My name's James. As always, so great to see all of your smiling faces out there. I hope you're all doing really, really well. And welcome to this, the next in our series of videos we call Quick Tips, where I try and cram as much of my scuba diving knowledge into a video 5 minutes or less on a given topic. And today we're talking about scuba cylinder valves. Specifically, I'm going to be giving you a breakdown of the parts of a scuba cylinder valve, how the valve actually operates and how you should work your scuba cylinder valve, and we'll be talking about some ideal maintenance. So if you haven't done so already, make your next dive on our subscribe button and we'll head to the workbench and check it out. First up then, let's go through the basic components and operation of how a scuba cylinder valve actually works. What I've done is I've taken a valve off of one of my cylinders here and I've disassembled it into its component parts so it's easy for you guys to follow. Let's start at the base then. This is called the dip tube. The idea of the dip tube is that this screws into the bottom of the cylinder valve, and then if you had any particles inside your cylinder, which you shouldn't have, but just in case you've got a little bit of moisture in there and that's created corrosion which has led to aluminium oxide or in the case of steel rust, you're going to get some flaking particles in there. If they were to enter the bottom of the cylinder valve there anytime you sort of went inverted in your dive, that would cause a big problem, probably a gas blockage, which is non-ideal. So by having this little tube attached to the bottom of the scuba cylinder valve, that means that if there is any kind of solid particles inside your cylinder anytime you go upside down, they're not going to enter into the actual valve itself. And then you have the main tank neck O-ring, which sits nice and on top there. All O-rings in this assembly are important, but obviously this nice big chunky one here is taking a massive amount of pressure from the cylinder and is holding the seal between the valve and the cylinder itself. So there we go. On this side here we have the burst disc. The burst disc is literally designed to fail. If you look on the inside there, you can just see that little copper washer. That is designed to explode in the event that this tank was accidentally overfilled, in which case that would burst, as the name suggests, allowing gas to escape out of that little hole in the side of the burst disc, which means that instead of this cylinder taking off like a projectile through somebody's house, it would actually just spin in situation as the excess gas, or all the gas, was vented from the valve itself. So a very important piece of safety equipment, and that just screws into the opposite side of the valve from the valve assembly. Then you have your DIN nut, which is commonly called a donut in the trade. There's two O-rings there, one on the front, one on the back, and that allows the scuba cylinder valve, at least most modern ones, to be converted from yoke to DIN by the addition or removal of this piece right here. So that just screws straight in there and you can tighten it up with a hex key or an Allen wrench, as it's so called. Now to the valve assembly itself. On this side, you have a copper washer, which is going to hold in place the actual high pressure seat. So this is what's doing all the work when it seals the valve off. That little piece of silicon on the inside there is what's going to sit against the valve assembly and allow there to be a seal so that when the cylinder is in the closed position, no gas is escaping through the valve orifice. So that screws into position via this stem right here. So the stem itself has a split piece into it, which lines up with the high pressure seat plug. And then that turning action there is what you're actually screwing in or screwing out to open or close the valve. Let me show you that in better detail. Then the stem itself needs to be sealed. So you're going to see that there's a small O-ring that assembles onto the stem. There's a neoprene washer, which creates the correct amount of space. And then this piece here is called the bonnet nut. The bonnet nut's job is to hold the stem and high pressure plug assembly together while securing it to the valve handle itself. So the stem actually passes, once you've got the O-ring and the spacer correct in there, will pass through, and then you have another washer on the other side just to prevent friction there. That's just a neoprene washer. And then if you notice, the actual shape of the stem itself is squared off. It's a square peg that goes in that square hole right there, see if I can get that angled correctly on the camera. So when you turn your valve handle, it's biting onto the square part of the stem, which is going to rotate through the bonnet nut and turn the plug, which is going to either dial it in to seal or dial it out to open the valve for your scuba cylinder. And then that is all held in place and torsioned by this spring and this outer nut here. Right, let's deal with the big ugly elephant in the room, the quarter turn back. No, absolutely not, never, nobody does this anymore. If you were taught this way, the open your valve all the way, then turn it a quarter turn back, congratulations, I just updated you for free. You're welcome. It is what it is. Nobody does this anymore. A valve is either all the way open or all the way closed. There are no in-between positions. In olden times, the old style of valves, if they were left in the fully open position and then exposed to high ambient pressure, i.e. you go diving with it, the threads of the valves themselves could become damaged and compromised, which is why the quarter turn back rule was developed. Two things have happened since then. Scuba cylinder design has improved, and number two, a bunch of people died having their tank turned only a quarter turn open. If you jump into the water with your cylinder completely closed, you're going to realize pretty quickly that your cylinder is closed and you're not going to descend. However, if you enter the water with your cylinder just a quarter turned open because somebody closed your cylinder and then turned it a quarter turn back to open it a quarter turn, you might be able to breathe off of that okay at the surface, but as the ambient pressure increases, as you descend, that could cause a shutoff and that your valve will not have the ability to deliver enough gas for your regulator to function, and then you're out of air right at the beginning of the dive. Not enough gas being delivered. Suboptimal. So three quick tips then to make sure that doesn't happen to you. Number one, if somebody, a helpful dive master, boat captain, your buddy, tries to check your cylinder, be careful and check it again yourself after them. Only you are responsible for the operation of your cylinder valve. Second tip, always look at your SPG while taking your breaths off of your regulator when you're doing your pre-dive safety checks, because this is going to give you some important information. If you've got 3000 PSI or 210 bar in your cylinder and you breathe off of your regulators and that needle doesn't move and it holds steady, your cylinder is open fully. If your cylinder is just on a little crack and you breathe off of that regulator, what you're going to see is either the needle is going to wobble a little bit or it will drop and slowly creep back up again, drop and creep back up again. That is a good sign that your cylinder's not open all the way and you need to make some adjustments. So always look at that SPG while you're taking your demo breaths during your pre-dive safety check. And thirdly, follow the three-finger rule. So always when you're operating a cylinder valve, you should be able to do it with three fingers. You should be able to dial it all the way into closed with three fingers and all the way open with three fingers. You should never need to grab hold of the valve and wrench it like the throttle on a motorbike. If you do, that is a good sign that that scuba cylinder valve needs to be serviced. So on that subject then, let's talk about ideal maintenance. As you may remember from the sixth video in our quick tip series where we looked at cylinder markings, every cylinder in the United States at least has to go through a visual inspection every year. And to do a visual inspection, the inspector has to take the valve off of the cylinder so they can inspect the inside of the cylinder and make sure it's still in good condition. That is the optimum time to get your valve serviced. So to do a valve service is very, very simple. You disassemble the valve as I've done here. All of the durable parts, the metal parts, get a nice soak in an ultrasonic bath. You can even use a little bit of vinegar in there, bring up the acidity to help clean out any corrosion or any parts of that, like that. And then all of the replaceable parts get replaced. That can include the neoprene washers, which get a little bit thin over continual use. Of course, all the O-rings, the high pressure seat itself can be thrown away and a new one installed. We can check the condition of the copper washer. If it still looks good, it can be reused, if not replaced. And of course, the O-ring on the neck of the cylinder and the O-rings on the donut. And then once all the wear and tear parts have been replaced, it's just a case of reassembly. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, probably more information than you ever thought you were going to need about the scuba cylinder valve on your scuba cylinders. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something from it. If you did, give it the old thumbs up, share it with your friends, and make your next dive on our subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Really helps us out to keep making these videos. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, my name's James. This was your quick tips video for this week from Divers Ready. Dive safe, dive often.